During the installation, we install a series of services. These services make up all the subsystems in the PI server. So I can look at these the way I would look at any other set of services in Windows. And if I can demonstrate, I'll go into the Start menu and just choose Run. Well, I can choose Run and then services.msc. Or if you're more into the graphical user interface, just choose Start. And you may find services in a couple different places. If you go into Administrative Tools, you'll find it under Services. Also, if you go into Control Panel, you'll also find Administrative Tools, and you'll find Services there. So, one way or another, go ahead and launch Services. I'll go ahead and make this bigger. If you scroll down, you'll see the services that we just installed. Here are all the different PI services, or we also call them the PI subsystems. Now, you'll notice almost all of these are set to automatic. I had that choice when I did the install. And also almost all of them are currently shut down. PI Network Manager is running because I've been running some local clients that use that as a communications mechanism. We'll talk more about that later. But the different subsystems or the different services can be seen in the traditional tools, but you can also see them in the tools that we ship with our PI system management tools. And I'll demonstrate. I'll go ahead and choose Start. And from within the Start menu, all programs, I'll choose PI System. And within PI System, I'll choose PI System Management Tools. And when this launches, what we'll see is this is a set of system management tools that allow us to do various system management tasks using a graphical user interface. Now, since the PI server has not been started yet, if I try to look at the different processes right now, the PI services, I won't see anything. It's just going to come up with a blank because PI server is not running at this point. But to recap, basically the PI system is going to install a series of services that make up how the PI system gets its job done. I'm going to describe now the core subsystems that make up the PI server. First of all, there's the snapshot subsystem. This is the subsystem responsible for looking at current data, handling current data. Snapshot data is passed on to the archive, and the archive subsystem takes care of it at that point, storing it to disk. It's also responsible for retrieving data back off of disk. So if one day somebody says, I can't see any data in PI, well, chances are you need to go look at the archive subsystem. The update manager is a subsystem for allowing different subsystems to do what we call a sign up for updates. Being able to keep apprised of any changes to the other parts of the system. Like, for example, if somebody creates new points, the update manager will allow the interfaces to pick that up without having to stop and start the interfaces. Now, again, we'll talk a lot more about that a little later on. The base subsystem is in control of the point database, creating points, etc. The message subsystem is simply a message logger. And PI SQL subsystem is I suppose the best way to describe it is to call it an ODBC driver. It is a subsystem that allows the PI server to share its data with ODBC compliant client applications, like relational database clients, like Crystal Reports and things like that. PI is not a relational database, but thanks to the PI SQL subsystem, it can imitate one. The redirector is what we're using for facilitating communication between COM connectors and external archives. This would be third-party historians. We'll talk more about that a little later on. We can also get data from relational databases using COM connectors. And then finally, we have a backup subsystem and a license subsystem for handling those two functions. And in addition to these, we also have these subsystems, we have utilities. Of course, any system like PI has utilities for doing various system management chores, and we do as well. Overlooked so far in our discussion is the PI Network Manager subsystem. PI Network Manager is kind of the master system that allows all the different subsystems to communicate with each other. So all of these, for example, when the archive subsystem needs to write a message to the message log saying that the archive has just shifted, it sends that message to PI Network Manager. PI Network Manager tells the message log that it's supposed to write a message, and that's how the communication works. It's all doing it through what you'll sometimes hear described as RPCs, or remote procedure calls. In any event, back to the list of systems. The interfaces are those components that will gather data. Typically, interfaces are getting data from live sources. We do have a couple of exceptions to the rule. The random and ramp soak interface are all just random number generators, and we use that for training purposes. And we do have these interfaces right here, PyPing, PerfMon, and PySNMP. They don't retrieve data externally so much as just kind of measure things that are either internal to the computer or some local things. For example, the PyPing interface is going to measure the ping rate between wherever it's currently installed and external computers. So it gives a good measure of latency, for example, within your system. The PyPerfMon can be used for monitoring the Windows counters, the performance counters, things like network usage, CPU usage, that type of thing. Network I/O, all that can be monitored by PerfMon and stored in Py tags. And then for SNMP devices like routers or switches or even printers, anything that publishes its process data or its information performance data using the SNMP protocol, well, the SNMP interface can read that. So these three things, we call these, these are basically demo interfaces. They're not the fully licensed version, so there are some restrictions, which we'll describe more a little later on. But those are fairly useful interfaces to have for diagnosing problems on your local machines. These server applications here include various things that, while not critical to the operation of Pi, still give great value. So for example, this is a simple calculation engine, and this is a recalculator so that if you change the historical data, we can recalculate those calculations. These two subsystems are in support of our event tracking or batch system, so that we can measure repeated events, comparing, for example, shift to shift, or comparing one batch of product to another batch of product made months or weeks later. Totalizer system simply does kind of a post-processing, doing typically totalizations, but it can also do other things like averages, standard deviations, etc. We have an alarm subsystem to generate alarms. We have an SQC alarm subsystem for doing statistical quality control alarms. And we have something called Analysis Framework. Analysis Framework really is our asset database tool. And by asset database, we mean a mechanism to allow people to find things in reference to assets, not necessarily by doing tag searches using kind of a naming convention. Instead of that, building an asset database and then making the Pi server more asset centered than tag centered. Again, we'll discuss a lot more of that later on. So in summary, all these subsystems, these make up what we call the Pi server.